Hey, I'm here with the first week of the CBDL and Uber's draft league. I've said this intro like two times already, but we tried the land timer and it kinda worked, but also kinda didn't. Like, we played one turn of the match and then just didn't connect anymore. It was just saying communicating. So yeah, anyways, this is the first week of the CBDL. I'm playing against Scoot, the coach of the Mississippi Morpeko. I've already played the first turn against him, so I already know what I was leading and what he was leading. I was leading Garchomp because I didn't expect the Weezing lead, because my original plan was to just lead Mewtwo, but he leads Weezing. Yeah. And then I switched into Ditto and noticed that I'm in a bad position. But yeah, let's salvage this. I think it's doable. So yeah, he has Togekiss, Weezing, Dracovish, Heatran, Samusenta and Tyranitar. I mean, I already wrote it down, obviously. I'm gonna type him good luck and have fun again. I'm already wasting timer. Oh, my bad. Even though I already know what I'm gonna do this turn. But yeah. He toxic spikes. I'm going into Regieleki. I mean, it gets poisoned, but I don't really care. And I wanna spin the toxic spikes away. So yeah. All my Pokemon are named after Mario characters this week. Because why not? Yeah. Ooh, he switches into Heatran. That's very interesting. And totally not what I expected. Thing is, do I just wanna rapid spin? I think I just wanna rapid spin. I don't care if Regieleki dies. I mean, I do care a bit. But it's not that bad if it dies. And I definitely don't want the toxic spikes around. He switches into Heatran. I mean, he's Weezing and I can't touch his Heatran, but still. Goes to Tyranitar. I am very intrigued. Okay, he goes to Tyranitar. He's going to get a lot of chip damage on my Regieleki. Way more than I would want. But yeah, I think I'm just gonna reflect here. I mean, the only important part of Regieleki is that it gets the screens up, to be honest. So I'm fully considering just sacking it for the screens. It's going Fire Punch. It's going Fire Punch. What does he expect me to bring in? And why does my pen not work anymore? That's a problem. I mean, okay, would make sense to go into that, but still. So he has Fire Punch. I was more expecting something like an Ice Beam for my Garchomp. He could go Ice Beam this time. He doesn't. That's good. That's very good. It'd suck if he would. I think I'm just going to Stealth Rock here. let's see what he does. I'm not sure if I would even KO him with an earthquake because I'm not very offensive. I mean, I am a sword stance scout jump, but without the sword stance, I'm not that strong. So he goes into his wheezing, which basically means a free switch into my Mewtwo for me. He has the send up, which is a problem because Draco Vision now outspeeds everything. But I think I should be able to deal with that. I have a little chip on the Tyranitar, which could be really nice. Oh, he goes for Will-O-Wisp, I don't like that. I mean, I have the Lumberry, but they didn't pack the Lumberry for a Will-O-Wisp. But I'm just gonna nasty plot. I don't care. There's already no sand anymore, so he's not Smooth Rock on his Tyranitar. And I don't think there's a way he lifts my attack after a nasty plot. Oh well, there is a way if he is AV. And he could totally be AV with him using Fire Punch and High Horsepower till now. But I think I'm fine with finding out, because I still have my Reflect up. Or at least I should. Yeah, definitely should still have my Reflect up. So let's see if he survives. And he doesn't. That's great. Okay, I think I live a hit from the Dracovish because of the Reflect. Right? I think I should. And if he's not Sandrush, then he needs to be Scarfed, and then he shouldn't kill me either way. Yeah, I think I should be fine under behind the Reflect. He goes into his Heatran. Does Heatran survive? Or does he just want to buy a turn? Okay, how many turns of Reflect do I have? Two. Oh, that's fine. I definitely don't want to run. Just gonna Aura Sphere this. Maybe it's Scarf. I think I live red. Yeah. I mean, now my Mewtwo is very low, which isn't optimal, but he can't set up his sand anymore, so his Dracovish isn't that threatening, because it only has like two turns left, where it really does a lot of damage. I mean, this thing is obviously threatening. But I think I'm fine with just going into my Rillaboom. I'm going into my Chomp, actually. I'm sacking my Chomp, kinda. Just to get some damage on this. And to see if it's Scarf or Band or something like this. He goes Crunch, that shouldn't do much, no. Yeah. Ooh, it's Life Orb. And he gets Sand Chip. That's also great. I mean, I think he definitely has to switch this turn. Do I need my Mewtwo? Kinda yes, kinda no. I'm making the aggressive play and switching into Mewtwo. And he doesn't switch, that's really bad. That's really bad. How does he not switch? Well, okay. Would that even have KO'd me? I don't think so, to be honest. I don't think there's a way that this kills me. But that's fine. I think Summer Center KOs itself, right? Probably. But I don't wanna risk it. I don't think I KO it if I just grassy glide with its defense boost. Also the switch-ins take more damage. I mean Weezing was kinda obvious, but I still feel like I had to go for the wood hammer. It still does a decent amount of damage. That's totally fine. Spikes again. Thing is, do I care about the T-spikes at this point? Kinda yes, kinda no. He doesn't really have recovery other than on his Togekiss. I think I can just kill the Togekiss. I think I'm just going on the offense here and not rapid spinning. I mean, whatever he goes into, I outspeed it. And with this thing I can just reflect if I want to. Or I can preserve my fastball. I think I'm actually gonna preserve my fastball, right? Yeah. Goes for earthquake, that does nothing. He is life orb as well, so he's not choice scuff. Yeah, show me your wood hammer switching. You don't have any. Togekiss is not a switch into Rillaboom wood hammer. Like, I think it should do over 50%. Oh, especially with the Stealth Rocks. He's not even heavy duty boots. Oh, his Citrus. Okay, that makes me unsure if I KO. But I know that he doesn't outspeed my Regieleki, so I think I can just go for another Wood Hammer anyways. Right. Well, depending on... I mean, he will just kill me if he outspeeds me, but he shouldn't be able to. I mean, he can't be scarfed. I mean, I saw the Citrus. So I think it KOs, but I'm not sure. And it doesn't even come close. How did I think? Wait, I lost my aggressor terrain. Okay, that was my bad. I sacked my Rillaboom for nothing. But I'm still in a decent position. My fastball still got enough life in it to just thunderbolt everything. One thing I can already say is that I definitely didn't play this match that clean, well, like as clean as I wanted to. I mean, I don't really blame myself for sacking my Mewtwo for an offensive switching, because I was sure that he will switch out, but he didn't. So I just T-bolt this red. Do I do enough damage if I T-bolt this? Most likely. And even if I don't, I win afterwards with my mons, so it's fine. I can risk it. So yeah, let's see his Summer Center moveset. Interesting information. Oh, I even get plus 2 instead of plus 1 because I copied a plus 1 and then I get plus 1 again. That's crazy. Oh boy. Ditto the perfect Sation and Summer Center counter. Who would have thought? I'm just gonna close combat. I don't feel like missing my move today. I didn't even KO. But then he shouldn't be able to KO me as well, so it doesn't matter. Oh, he KOs himself with life up anyways. So yeah, GG. Nice. I feel like there were some parts where I could have played better. Especially my lead was kinda bad, because it was kinda obvious that he would lead Weezing, but he could have just instantly lost against Mewtwo. Could have just plotted in his face and at full. The Summer Center doesn't even KO me with Trespender Crunch. So I really wasn't expecting the Weezing lead. But yeah, GG's to Scoots. We start week one off with a win. That's always nice. And yeah. I'll see you for the next battle of the league. Bye.